it's very important that you know what's going on around you. So today I'm going to talk about incentives. I'm going to talk about law and order and what gives people the incentive to follow along with society's norms and what forces people away from the norm. Basically, I'm going to talk about security and how this economic collapse is going to affect security, your security. Here's the thing, if a college graduate can't find a job or ends up working a job that is low paying and it's the type of job that he or she would have been working if he or she decided to never go to college or if he or she would have dropped out of high school, that person gets to a point where they realize that, okay, I follow the rules, I did everything that I was supposed to do, I acquired a degree, a meaningful four-year degree, and it hasn't paid off for me. I've done everything that I was supposed to do, but I haven't seen any results. When that happens, people question the entire system. People question whether it's a good idea for them to be going along with this system. And when people lose the incentive, the basically follow along with what society establishes is the norm, then you pretty much have normlessness. Anomie is something, well, it's called normlessness. It's basically a state of not having a connection to society. It's almost like being disconnected from the world. And I think a lot of people are becoming disconnected from the society, from the central moral code and, you know, the law and everything. And I think that's one of the reasons why you're going to see crime increase, because people are going to realize that, hey, my brother and sister went to college, they did all this, and now look, I mean, they can't find a job. They're no better off than the people who didn't do it, didn't follow along that structure. So what good is the structure? When that happens, and I think it is happening, people are going to move away from the central moral code, the laws, and all that stuff, because it's not going to mean anything to them. They're going to realize that there's really no incentive to follow along with that stuff. And when that happens, and like I said, I think it's happening, and it's going to happen more in the future, you're going to see a lot more crime. And I think that's a really big problem when people get to the point that they almost feel like they have nothing to lose. And that's a major concern to me. I don't know, are you seeing that happening in your neighborhood? Are you seeing that happening in your town? Because I think it's been happening for a while, but I think you're going to see an increase in individuals who are like that. A lot of people have stayed in line, so to speak, because they're striving towards material goods. They want that big house, that nice car. They want that money. And that's why they pretty much went along with what society established as the norm. But a lot of people are going to lose access to those goods, to those things. And when that happens, people are going to reevaluate what they think about the entire system. Because for some people, if they can't have the nice car, if they can't have the big house, if they can't have that boat, then, you know, they don't really give a damn. I guess it's one of the reasons why I own a gun, and obviously you can tell by my selection of gun that I'm obviously worried about security, because I'm worried about that moment when some police officer says, hey, you, get over there, and people think to themselves, no. You know, like, why am I listening to you? I mean, you shoot me... So what? I don't have anything. I lost my house, my car, everything. I mean, I'm going to be poor to the day I die. I mean, why am I listening to you? You know, matter of fact, you know, I got a gun too. Generally, it's always like a small percentage of people who are like that. People who just don't connect to the society. They're not always criminals, but they're not really, they don't have a real investment in society. They're not stakeholders in what happens in this country. But I think that group is going to grow a lot more. So you guys tell me what you think about that. So it's one of the reasons why I implore people to get a gun, because I think it'll be worth it just for security. And not only for that, I mean, you may end up using it for other things, but I'm really thinking that buying a gun is really important at this point. It doesn't mean you should freak out or anything. It just means that you should be mindful of what's going on around you. Hey, I picked up these dumbbells. Okay, I picked up these dumbbells today. Man, these things are a lot heavier than they look. It's like a 40 pounder right here. Got about two of them actually. Decided to pick up something for the shooting because I haven't been shooting as much as I should be. So this is sort of like a target paper or whatever you call them. And I picked up some binoculars. Only 12 bucks, but you know, works pretty well for me. Figure it might be a good idea to see what's coming ahead. I mean, not really for an economic collapse, but really for any type of emergency situation. Might be kind of useful. I accidentally bought two 16 gauge packs of buckshot, so I had to go back and return it. And when I returned them, I replaced those buckshots with rifle slugs. So I got four more boxes of rifle slugs. So man, it's really expensive. Well, this one's $7.99 for a rifle slug. Again, $7.99. So ammo is not cheap up here.
Basically, I want to know, how do you think people are going to respond to this economic collapse? And are you seeing changes in people's behavior right now? Are you seeing normlessness? Are you seeing people become disconnected from society? Are you seeing people's behavior change as they lose their incentives? Or do you even believe in this whole incentive idea? Tell me what you think. So thank you for watching my videos. Please comment and have a good day. Bye.